That's right, Joshua. This Henniker home, as you can see, is still considered a total loss. It's boarded up and no one can live there. Investigators say they're still trying to determine if the suspect's children were with him at the home when he allegedly set the fire.
Investigators are still piecing together exactly what took place at this home in Henniker that went up in flames in October. Police say this man, Matthew Patinode, is responsible. According to court paperwork, the 47-year-old is accused of starting the fire at his wife's home on Colby Hill Road. They are separated, and the paperwork indicates that a pending divorce could be his motive. His wife has filed for divorce twice in the past year. Weeks before the fire, Patinode showed up at the home while his wife and her boyfriend were home. The paperwork reads that after seeing them leave a bedroom, Patinode said, "I guess we are going to have a bloodbath," and left the home. His wife immediately changed the locks after that incident. On the day of the fire, Patinode was watching the children at the home while his estranged wife was at work. Neighbors reported suspicious activity by Patinode at the home right before the fire. Throughout the day, one of them observed Patinode going back and forth between the house, trailer, and truck. Relatives of Patinode are documented saying he told them he didn't want anyone to have the home after the divorce was finalized, saying to one that if he can't have it, no one can. The paperwork says that Patinode put his children in the truck that day and went back in the home, returning with some of their belongings. Prosecutors believe he started the fire at around that time before he and the children drove off. Just a few minutes later, a passerby called 911 reporting the fire.
And the fire is believed to have been started in the basement near some plastic totes containing diesel fuel. A lighter was also found in that area that did not belong to Patinode's wife or her boyfriend. Patinode is free on $50,000 bail. Live in the studio, Melinda Davenport, WMUR News 9.